Welcome to Recipes for Life. I'm Dr. Beth. Thanks for joining us today. Today's show I have entitled Rediscovering Pasta. And I've titled it that way because for so many years I avoided pasta because it was considered to be a fattening food. It had a very high glycemic index, it was processed. But today, we have some fantastic, much healthier choices when it comes to pasta. When you're shopping for pasta, you want to look for a whole grain pasta. So you're going to find whole wheat pastas, you're going to find pastas made from wheat, amaranth, quinoa, Jerusalem artichoke, and all kinds of fun ingredients. And the fun thing about whole grain pasta is it has a much higher protein content, it has a much higher fiber content, and it contains a lot more nutrients than pasta made from white flour would contain. And these together create a glycemic index that is much healthier and is going to be much more figure friendly. And I've got three great recipes that are very easy and fast to make that I'm going to be sharing with you today. So when it comes to eating pasta, one of the most important things to keep in mind is serving size. If you look at the box or the package, the serving size is listed at only 2 ounces. So I've measured 2 ounces out for you so you can see exactly what it looks like, at least when it's raw. And I'll show you later what it looks like when it's cooked. But this 2 ounce portion is actually a little bit deceptive because it refers to the average size portion, meaning a smaller person, such as myself, does not need to eat that full 2 ounces. Or someone like the size of my husband, Michael, do you want to come in here? Someone the size of Michael could easily eat a 2 ounce portion. Now, if I took off my shoes, he is literally a full foot taller than me and actually weighs double what I weigh. So there's no way that I could eat as much as he can eat and actually stay the size that I am. So serving size is very important that you eat according to not only the weight that you are, but the weight that you want to stay at. So for my first pasta dish today, I'm going to be making a spinach pesto pasta. It is very easy to make using very simple classic ingredients. We're going to be using, for the pesto, it'll be lemon juice, olive oil, some Parmesan cheese, spinach, some basil that I just picked this morning, and of course garlic. I'm going to be using this penne pasta, which is a whole wheat. And so again, it's got lots of fiber, lots of protein. And I'm going to be making 2 servings. So I want to add a little bit of, this was my 2 ounce, 1 serving. And that brings us to 4 ounces. So 2 servings. And I've got my water already boiling. And I've got quite a bit of water here. You want to give your pasta lots of room. I'm going to add a little bit of sea salt. And this actually does flavor the pasta, but it also helps make it cook a little bit faster. And we just want to keep our eye on that so it doesn't boil over too quickly. Grab my salt for the pesto. So what we're going to do is I'm going to take my basil, and I've got probably about 2 cups here that's just cleaned. Put it right into my processor. And then I want to take about 1 cup or so of spinach. I'm going to add in 2 cloves of garlic, a little bit of lemon juice, maybe 2 tablespoons, a little bit of sea salt, maybe about 1/2 teaspoon is plenty. and get that started. What I'm gonna do after I turn this on is I'm gonna start drizzling in the olive oil. And so we'll get it all mixed together that way. So that was maybe a quarter cup of olive oil at the most. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to add about a quarter cup of my, I've got some really nice shredded Parmesan here. I'm going to keep my eye on that pasta, I don't want it to boil over. And I want to add a little bit of Italian seasoning. Maybe about a teaspoon. Now you could certainly add more cheese at this point if you want, but what's gonna happen is we're not gonna be using all of this pesto. And you could add certainly other kinds of cheese, you could add pine nuts, you could add cayenne pepper. You could really make it however you like, but we won't be using it all, mixing it in with that amount of pasta. So the other step I will be doing is right before the pasta's done, I'm gonna be adding in the rest of this spinach, and we're gonna let it wilt down. And doing it that way actually releases the oxalic acid, which helps you then utilize all of the calcium in the spinach. And then we're gonna mix everything together, add some heirloom tomato halves and top it off with a little cheese, and that's it. So simple. So let's see how that pasta's doing. Just gave it a little fork test and it is very close to done. Just gonna leave it in one more minute before I add my pasta. So I'm ready to add my spinach. And I know this looks like a lot of spinach for two people, but it really does wilt way down. And I think one of the other important aspects about pasta is balancing it with the proper amount of vegetables. And if you listen to my teaching on what is a balanced diet, I always talk about one part protein, one part carbohydrate, and two parts vegetables to make up a balanced meal. So as you can see, I'm gonna be having my one part carb, two parts vegetables, and then the cheese in there is going to be a sufficient amount of protein, but you could certainly add a couple ounces of a piece of grilled chicken or fish on there. So just takes moments for that spinach to get wilted. So I'm going to go ahead and drain out my water. You can see that spinach just melted down into nothing. So now I'm going to add, you can really add as much pesto as you want, but because of that raw garlic, it is going to have a pretty strong flavor. So I'm going to just start out with maybe about 4 tablespoons. And I'm just going to mix that all together. And I'm gonna add probably about a cup. I've got some beautiful little fresh heirloom tomatoes that I just cut in half. Really beautiful color, nice fresh ingredients. This smells so awesome. And then my last ingredient is I've got a combination of Parmesan, Romano, and Asiago. Really, really strong, beautiful flavors. And this is actually a raw milk cheese, which I absolutely love. And so I'm just gonna sprinkle some of that on, get it melted in a little bit. And again, I made 2 servings, but there is no way that I could eat half that much pasta. Although Michael probably could. He works a lot harder than I do. So you can see how beautiful, not only how beautiful this dish is, but how easy and fast it was to make. And right there is actually a balanced meal. We've got our complex carb with our whole grain pasta. We've got the tomatoes and spinach and basil and garlic for our vegetables. And then that beautiful raw cheese for our protein. But as I mentioned, you could easily add a 2-3 ounce serving of fish or chicken alongside here. And you have a beautiful, healthy meal. Next, I want to make asparagus pasta is what I called it. We're going to be using an angel hair. And by the way, you can also get a lot of these whole grain pastas in gluten-free. Now, I'm not going to be using those today, but the next one we're going to make is with an angel hair with asparagus. And again, so fast and absolutely delicious. So I've got 3 ounces of my Jerusalem artichoke spaghetti pasta here. Actually, it's an angel hair. So 3 ounces, 2 ounces for Michael, 1 ounce for me. My water's boiling, so I'm gonna again go ahead and add my salt. And being I'm only making 3 ounces, I know that pot looks a little small, but that will collapse down in just a few minutes. So I've got my pan here on medium low, and I'm gonna go ahead and put my olive oil in. Just a few tablespoons, and I'm gonna be sauteing up. I've got about 3 large cloves of garlic I just sliced up. So I'm just gonna get that started. It's a little warm. And grab my pasta here. Get that all down in the water. So my next ingredient is my asparagus. So I've got about 10 ounces of fresh asparagus here. I've already clipped off the edges. And I'm just gonna cut these into approximately 1-inch pieces. I know this kind of does look like a lot of asparagus for 2 people, but it really does shrink down, and we're just going to put it right in with our garlic. And then I'm going to add, I've got some portobello mushroom slices here, a couple cups. Just need to give these a quick stir. And then I'm gonna add 1/3 cup of an organic free-range chicken broth. Need to find my markings. Yep. And then that just needs to saute up. It really does not take long at all. And my last ingredients for this dish are gonna be some of that three cheese from the raw milk that I love so much from the first recipe. We're gonna add a little bit of crushed red pepper, sea salt, and I'll just add a little bit of oregano right now. Mushrooms just soak up all those that garlic and the oregano flavor. I wanted to mention to you, you know, that in Italy, pasta is eaten at least once a day. But they do maintain very small portions. And also in Italy, their culture is very different because they eat very few processed foods compared to Americans. And they walk 3, 4, 5, 6 miles, or sometimes bike, every day. This is a normal part of their lifestyle and culture. Whereas, you know, for most of us, if we're gonna, you know, walk 3 miles, it's either, you know, going to do our exercise or, you know, going to the gym or the treadmill or whatnot. So they have a higher metabolic rate just because of their more active lifestyle, where they're biking and walking to and fro their work or to the market. And so for this reason, in Italy, you have a significantly lower obesity and overweight incidence in their population compared to Americans, who tend to be much more sedentary and much have a diet much higher in processed foods. So the concept that eating pasta is going to make you overweight is not really true if you look at the culture in Italy compared to ours. I just added some red cayenne pepper. You can add as much as you like. We're gonna add that cheese that I talked about, as much as you like. A little bit of sea salt. And again, that's gonna be to taste. And then I'm gonna add my pasta. And that is it. Very simple, fresh and delicious. This has probably become my most favorite pasta dish, maybe because I am absolutely crazy about the asparagus. Absolutely love asparagus. It increases glutathione in the body, which is a detox nutrient, and it's extremely anti-cancer. So let's get that plated up. I don't know why the pasta always comes out easier. Get lots of asparagus and mushrooms and cheese. Few little pinches of extra cheese on top. So for our last recipe today, I'm going to be making a classic tuna noodle hot dish. And as you know, typically these are made with an egg noodle, and I did find a whole wheat egg noodle that has even more protein than a typical whole wheat noodle because of the eggs in it. So one serving actually has 10 grams of protein, which is obviously a significant amount of protein for pasta. So I'm going to be measuring out my 3 ounces. And I know that all of you probably do not have a scale like this. However, it was extremely affordable. And it is a really good idea so that you can manage your serving sizes. So I'm going to get my saute going first. Again, I've got my pan on medium low. I'm going to add my onion, garlic, and olive oil. And then after a few minutes, I'll add my pasta to the noodles because this does take a little bit longer. And I don't want the pasta to be sitting there too long in that water. I don't want it to get mushy. So we're starting out with, as I mentioned, I've got maybe 4 cloves of garlic. You don't have to use that many, but I find that it really does add quite a bit of flavor. And I've got about a small onion here that I chopped up. Again, I don't want that too hot. And after a few minutes, I'm going to be adding, I've got about 1.5 cups of celery here. I'm going to be adding a little bit of chicken broth. And then for my cream, typically these recipes are made with a like a cream of chicken or a cream of celery or cream of mushroom soup. But I'm not going to be using those because they're full of artificial ingredients. And in particular, MSG. We do not want to be using a monosodium glutamate in our food, which does cause weight gain. And so instead of that, in order to give the this recipe its creamy base, I'm going to be using a fat-free sour cream. Absolutely wonderful. It does not have any hormones. It is an absolute wonderful substitute for all those cream of type soups. So it looks like I'm ready to add my celery. Just let that cook down for, you know, maybe 5, even 10 minutes. If you want your celery a little bit more crunchy, you certainly don't have to cook it that long. My peas are organic, frozen, and I've let them thaw. And I've got just a little over 1 cup there for our vegetable. And then finally for our tuna, I have got, yes, this is canned tuna. And it is a wild albacore, which is the white tuna. Very high in omega-3s, low in mercury. So this is a sustainable, meaning that it's good for the environment, it's dolphin safe. And this is a wonderful tuna that that you can get at most health food stores or health food section of your grocery store. So my celery and onions are pretty much ready to go here. So I'm going to go ahead and add the rest of my ingredients. And with this chicken broth, keep it close because you might want to add more later. And I'm going to want about 1 cup of this, the fat-free sour cream. Fine to eyeball it. Just get that stirred up. And my tuna and the cheese, I'm gonna wait until the very last when the pasta is done. You can add black pepper, red pepper, just season it to however you like it. So our tuna noodle hot dish is ready. So we have finished our tuna noodle hot dish with the egg noodles, and we also have our spinach pesto pasta and our asparagus with angel hair pastas. Of these two could be served alone, or you could add a small piece of chicken or fish on the side to boost the protein content even higher. So I want to thank you today for joining us on Recipes for Life. And I want to remind you that as you are making healthier choices, that you can include pasta as part of your healthy diet. I want to remind you that serving sizes are very important, and to choose whole grain pasta, which is high in protein and fiber, which is the way that God intended grains to be. So I want to encourage you to visit our website, www.blpublications.com, where you'll find lots of books and other helpful information to help you in your health journey. So we wish God's blessings upon you and your health, and wish you well.
Dr. Beth is a nationally known author, counselor, and speaker in the nutritional industry. You can learn more from Dr. Beth about her principles of biblical nutrition from her books, God Wants You Well, Spewed, How to Cast Out Lukewarm Christianity Through Fasting and a Fasted Lifestyle, and Recipes for Life with 200 Simple and Delicious Recipes. You can get all three books today for just $40 plus shipping and handling. Thank you, and God bless your health.